greetings. When you begin to think we are in the last days, you should probably review Revelation. Well, to keep things in perspective, you should conduct a bit of an overview. I accomplished this by copying the whole book of Revelation into an Excel spreadsheet. In total, Revelation has 22 chapters. After some header rows in the spreadsheet, beginning on row 4, it completes with Revelation 22:21 on row 407. That means the whole book of Revelation has 404 verses. Well, let's walk through the 22 chapters in this overview. This is part 1. Chapter 1. John introduces himself and his vision of Jesus. This includes a list of the seven churches to send this message to, and it includes an imagery of seven candlesticks and seven stars. Chapter 2 begins the message to the seven churches, Ephesus, Smyrna, Pergamos, and Thyatira in Chapter 2, and in Chapter 3, Sardis, Philadelphia, and Laodicea. Chapter 3 ends with, He that hath an ear to hear, let him hear what the Spirit saith unto the churches. And this, interestingly, is the last mention of the church until Revelation 22:16. You can ponder that fact and what it might mean as you review the rest of Revelation. Now, using a spreadsheet might seem sacrilegious to someone, but I found it a great way to organize and follow the various themes and lists in Revelation. Some things to keep track of: trumpets, seals, angels, more angels, and seven more angels, and finally, the Lamb. So in these slides to follow, I'll use yellow for trumpets, orange for seals, green for angels, blue for more angels, and pink for the final set of seven angels. And I'll number them on the side of the slide as appropriate. And the Lamb I'll highlight with red with white lettering. Let's move on to chapter 4. Verse 1 begins with the voice of trumpet number 1. Then there are 24 elders and seven lamps, which are the seven spirits of God. Next, four beasts are mentioned, all saying, Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. Chapter 5. Introduction of a book with seven seals on it. Who is worthy to open the book and loosen the seals thereof? Answer, verse 6, the Lamb. And the Lamb is mentioned several more times in chapter 5. Chapter 6, the Lamb opens the first seal, a rider on a white horse. He rides to conquer. The Lamb opens seal number 2. A rider on a red horse rides and takes peace that people should kill each other. The Lamb opens seal number 3, and a rider on a black horse, a rider with balances. He calls out a measure of wheat for a penny. The Lamb opens seal number 4, a rider on a pale horse. The rider's name is Death, and hell follows him. He's given power to kill one quarter of people with sword, hunger, death, and beasts. The Lamb opens seal number 5. Under the altar, the souls of them slain for the word of God cry out. They cry, How long before you judge, O God? Then the Lamb opens seal number 6. The great earthquake, and the sun becomes black, and the moon becomes blood. Stars of heaven fall, maybe a meteor shower. Mountains and islands are moved, and men go into hiding. Still part of seal 6 in chapter 7. Four angels hold the four winds, and they will hurt the earth and sea. But first, another angel delays them until 144,000 of all the tribes of Israel are sealed. Verses 9 through 17 detail much praise for the Lamb of God by the elders and the martyrs clothed in white, killed during the tribulation. Chapter 8, the Lamb opens seal number 7. Silence in heaven for about half an hour, and then seven trumpets are handed to seven angels. The first angel blows his trumpet. Hail and fire mingled with blood, and a third of all the trees are burnt, and all the grass is burnt. The second angel blows his trumpet, and as it were a great mountain burning with fire is cast into the sea, and a third of the sea becomes blood. A third of the sea creatures die, and a third of ships are destroyed. The third angel blows his trumpet, and a great star from heaven fell on one third of the rivers and fountains of waters, where the waters come from. It's called wormwood, bitter waters, and many men died from the waters. The fourth angel blows his trumpet, and a third of the sun is smitten, a third of the moon, and a third of the stars. An angel cries out, "Woe, woe, woe," for reason of the next three trumpets, as if those first four were not bad enough. The fifth angel blows his trumpet. A star or angel with a key to the bottomless pit is released. He goes to earth and locusts come out of the pit of hell and torment men for 5 months. This was the first woe. The sixth angel blows his trumpet. Four angels are loosed to slay one third of men, and the 200 million man army is then mentioned. This is the second woe. The seventh angel is clothed with a rainbow, and this angel speaks great oaths by God to complete the mystery of God declared by the prophets. Now there's a verse in chapter 10 which gave me some pause and cause to ponder. Revelation 10:7. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished as he has declared to his servants the prophets. The words there do not imply an intermission or a halftime situation, do they? But this verse does bring to mind an aspect of Daniel's prophecy of the 70 weeks. Daniel 9:24, 70 weeks are decreed upon thy people and upon thy holy city, to finish transgressions and to make an end of sins, and to make reconciliation for iniquity, and to bring in everlasting righteousness, and to seal up the vision and prophecy, and to anoint the most holy. There is an aspect or implication of completion conveyed by this verse which undermines the assertion this is midway through the tribulation. But in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished as he has declared to his servants the prophets. I don't have an absolute or confirmed meaning, so I will leave my own speculation out of this. In chapter 11, seal number 7 continues. The two witnesses are introduced, and they prophesy for 1,260 days. Fire comes out of their mouths. They can stop rain for 3.5 years. They will be killed. Their dead bodies shall lay in the street for 3.5 days. Then they shall be resurrected by God. They ascend into heaven as their enemies watch. And another great earthquake collapses one-tenth of the city. In chapter 12, the sign of the woman clothed with the sun, moon at her feet, wearing 12 stars in her crown, travailing in birth, delivering a son. And a second sign in the heavens, a dragon, whose tail draws a third part of the stars of heaven to earth. And the sun is caught up to God, and the woman hides for 1,260 days. And Michael and his angels fight the dragon and his angels. I'll be honest, as I was reading Revelation and developing this video content, I thought only the last 3.5 years were nasty, those of the Great Tribulation. But all the things I have just covered are classically taught as the first half of the tribulation, Daniel's 70th week. Let's just review for a moment all the bad things that have already happened. The first rider on the white horse brings war, conquest. The second rider on a red horse takes peace from the world that we should kill each other. The third rider on black horse holds balances and causes economic problems. The fourth rider, named Death, on a pale horse, has the power of causing one quarter of the earth to die by sword, hunger, death, and beasts. Those are just the first four seals. The fifth seal is the lament and cry of the slain martyrs. During the sixth seal, there is a great earthquake, Revelation 6:12. The sun goes black and the moon goes red. Stars fall to earth, this may be as meteors. Mountains and islands are moved, and all men hide themselves. During the seventh seal, there is a half-hour silence in heaven, then seven angels with seven trumpets. A censer with fire from the altar is cast down to earth, and there are voices, thunder, lightning, and another earthquake. Now come the seven angels with seven trumpets. Angel number one, hail and fire with blood, and a third of trees and all of the grass are burned. Angel two, a great mountain of fire cast into the sea. One third of the sea becomes blood, and one third of sea life is killed. Angel number three, wormwood, the burning star from heaven, and a third of water is polluted. Angel number four, one third of the sun, moon, and a third of the stars are dimmed. Angel 5, the woe number 1, locusts of iron from hell, 5 months of torment for men. Angel number 6 is the second woe, 4 angels of 4 winds, and they kill a third part of the men. And here again is an interesting scripture which can serve as context. Revelation 9:17, and thus I saw the horses in the vision, and them that sat on them. I believe this refers back to the four riders of the white, red, black, and pale horses. The riders and horses are described as having breastplates of fire and of jacinth and brimstone, and the heads of the horses were as the heads of lions, and out of their mouths issued fire and smoke and brimstone. Revelation 9:18, by these three were the third part of men killed, by the fire, and by the smoke, and by the brimstone which issued out of their mouths. By these three means the white, conquest, red, no peace, and pale, death. Those three horses. So before the halfway point, one third of all mankind may have been killed. Revelation 9:20, and the rest of the men which were not killed by these plagues, yet repented not. They still haven't repented of the works of their hands, that they should not worship devils and idols of gold and silver and brass and stone and of wood, which neither can see nor hear nor walk. Neither repented they of their murders, nor of their sorceries, nor of their fornication, nor of their thefts. So even before the great tribulation, there is a whole lot of death coming down the pipe. And yet men will not repent and bow before the God of heaven and earth. Luke 21:36. Be watching at all times, therefore, and praying that you will be worthy to escape from these things which are going to occur, and to stand before the Son of Man. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. In part 2, I will try to scan through the second half of Revelation.